Before we continue, I like to mention that this course is intended for intermediate level users. It means those of you who already use 3ds Max for modeling and rendering for quite some time. Now, for those of you who never used 3ds Max before or just starting out, I suggest you to take my Udemy course, which is designed for complete beginners. It will teach you from the very basic until you are able to create images like this on your own. Guaranteed. And I will give you a special 75% discount at the end of the video series if you are interested. Okay, let's get back to our tutorial. For the rest of this tutorial, I will be using shaded mode rather than the realistic mode so that my computer's GPU will not be overburdened, as my screen capture software also running in the background now. Next, let's set the system unit to centimeters. Now, let's create a box with this cube option turned on. This will create a perfect cube shape to be used as the placeholder for our blueprint images. Center this out to the origin by zeroing all of the coordinates down here. Right now, the size is not really matter as we're going to scale it later. Convert the box to an editable poly object. Go to the edge mode and select all and hit this split button. Now go to polygon mode and pick this polygon, then move it back, this one to side, and the top one to the bottom. Delete the rest of the polygons. Now let's create a standard material and name it front. Turn self illumination to 100 and click the diffuse map and add a bitmap and choose the front image that we created before. Turn on Show Material in Viewport. Now just drag this material onto the cube. As we can see, we have the front image shows up on all of the polygons now. Click drag this material to the side to copy it. Rename this to side and reassign the bitmap in a diffuse map slot to the side image. Then select the polygon for the side view and just drag the material into it. Select the bottom polygon and copy the material, rename it to top, and reassign the bitmap to the top image. Click drag the material to assign it to the bottom polygon. Now go to the front viewport, select these two polygons, the front and the top reference, and move it horizontally so the center match up the center of the world. After that, move it vertically so the root of the chair touches the ground plane. Okay, now go to the left viewport and move this polygon also so it's centered. And make it also touching the ground plane. Next, we create a box. Make sure the cube option is turned off now. Create it to follow this seed size. Now go to top viewport and match the top reference polygon position so the seed image conform nicely with the box. If we look at our original JPEG reference, we can see that the height of it is 68 cm overall. So let's create a box with that height. And scale our reference object so that the height match exactly the box height. Okay, now our reference is positioned and resized correctly. We need to lock its transformation so it won't budge if we accidentally try to move it. To do that, while it's selected, go to the hierarchy panel, link info, and lock all of this transformation. Okay. Save the file and we're going to move on to the real modeling process in the next video.